Thank you, Chief.
I will lead off with our questions. My first is, I notice your budget proposal that the funding for buildings, roads, and facilities remain flat compared to last year. However, I also notice that you no longer distinguish in your budget proposal between how much of this funding will be used for maintaining your existing infrastructure and how much will be used for building new buildings, roads, and facilities. So taking care of deferred with also increasing new. The Great American Outdoors Act provided you an additional $285 million annually over 5 years to address your deferred maintenance backlog, which has been estimated at $5.2 billion. I want to make sure that you will use the money requested in the budget to maintain what you currently have, or at least the extent that the remaining $4 billion backlog does not continue to grow. So how much of your proposed funding for buildings, roads, and facilities would go towards net maintenance versus new construction? You want to turn your...
Let me break that apart just a little bit, Senator, and I really appreciate the question. The Great America's Outdoors Act of the $285 million annually is a great start, and an updated number, we have a $5.9 billion backlog. $3.85 billion is for transportation, and just over $2 billion are for our non-transportation, our facilities, our admin facilities, our recreation, communication sites, and all the rest. And a significant criteria for the Great America Outdoors Act deferred maintenance projects are it must indicate how much deferred maintenance the project is going to create. So there's an example in your state, the Sherwood Campground Rehabilitation is a significant project out of Great America Outdoors Act, where we're investing $750,000 from the Legacy Restoration Fund, but it will take care of $1.1 million of deferred maintenance. In regards to our regular budget, it is flat. And it's not enough to get after our backlog, but we'd be happy to work with the committee on how we can do a better job at that, Senator.
Thank you. Thank you. Also, you mentioned your budget justification that Forest Service is the first federal law enforcement agency to require all of its law enforcement officers to wear body cameras. So that everyone knows what we are talking about, the Forest Service has implemented a nationwide body-worn camera and video evidence storage system. So why did you decide to do this, and what was the cost?
It's for accountability and transparency, Senator.
How's the law enforcement officers received this? Are they okay? Are they giving you any pushback?
No. I mean, yes, change is always something that we have to work through together, but overall, they are very receptive. We've been working on it for the last couple of years. They know it's coming. We did some testing in particular units. We had employee work groups to answer their questions. So we really worked on the change management model, and
it's working.
We're proud of our efforts.
Right. Yeah. Let me ask this question. This is off the cuff. You know, a lot of the forest fires have been horrible, and right now the season has started off in horrific. What I'm seeing out west right now, everyone's getting hit because of the heat wave. I also have concerns about how much timber that we just let go to waste. Is there any desire by your department to work and accelerate extracting some of that timber after it burns that will not regrow, but we can still use it for the market?
Yes, Senator, absolutely. We work with our multiple partners. I'll give you an example.
We had reports here that so much is wasted because by the time they get permits to go in, it's too late.
Yeah, well, we have to prioritize where we're going to go with the danger trees first that will have life and safety implications to our employees and the public. So we have some expedited environmental clearances processes. We still go through the environmental clearance to make sure we're making science-based decisions, and we are prioritizing.
That's to cut down a burnt tree that's dead?
Yes, sir.
What are they evaluating? It's dead. it's going to fall over and rot, or we can use it?
Yes, it can provide benefits in the ecosystem as well.
If you could give me some reports on what you do, they just, and I will say this with all due respect, it just seems like it's ridiculous that we don't salvage and be able to use that for a productive use that would be helping the economy. It helps basically the cost of timber for building, but also it's a resource we're wasting.
We do salvage restoration, Senator, but not every
forest fire?
Not on every tree that dies, depending on where it is in very steep terrain, et cetera.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. I have one other question. Let's go back to where Senator King, because it's so important, and I think I mentioned it. Senator King went into more details. I'd like to go into a little bit more details. On page 140 of your budget, it says that there is a number for acres treated that is different than the 2.65 million acres or 3.7 million acres you mentioned. It is acres that have effectively mitigated wildlife risk.
Wildfire risk?
Well, I'm sorry, wildfire risk. It says that your target for last year was 1.1 million acres and this year it's 1.4. It also looks like you haven't met your target in several years. How are the numbers different from the 2.65 million acres treated that you're proposing?
Senator, I'm proposing an additional 2.65 acres in addition to our targets that you see in that budget. Not having the numbers in front of me that you read off, I can't.
We'll share that with you and everything.
Yeah, we'd be glad to explain that.
Let me throw this at you and see what. I'm also told, and I think Senator King was alluding to this, there's an awful lot of acres that you all are treating that haven't been identified as high risk because you're just trying to, I guess,
exactly,
make sure it doesn't become high risk. But we're not treating the imminent danger of those high risk areas because they're on a rotation. That makes sense.
Yes,
that's what I understand. It
makes sense. And that's a part of this paradigm shift. It's not just treating more acres and any acres, those less high risk.
You know where the risk truly
is. We have the modeling and the science. We have incredible science capacity. We call it scenario investment planning by high.
What's preventing us from doing it? There's some impediment. It's either the environmental communities or just completely out.
It's funding, sir.
It's funding?
It's funding.
But I'm saying, if we see that you weren't, you know, once you identify with these models, but still yet we didn't approach that the past year, year before.
Well, our outputs or what we're held accountable for is just acres treated. And we're working with the Office of Management and Budget to have an outcome-based performance measure because some of the acres that we need to treat in the high-risk fire sheds or around high-risk communities, they might be really expensive.
Okay.
And less acres, and we need to show an outcome. We have to be held accountable something, but it needs to be an outcome-based, not just our units treating as many acres as they can, because that's the only performance measure we're holding them accountable.
I think you know this is of great interest to us, when is your retirement?
My retirement is the end of August.
Okay, now we've got a couple months here.
Mr.
Okay.
Chairman, I move a unanimous consent agreement that she's not being allowed to retire.
I would second that.
Sorry about that.
Ms. Christiansen, you know, I really appreciate, and I know that Senator King has, I'm sure everyone here, your direct honesty on what we have some challenges. If our committee could engage with you immediately before you leave, that would give us some direction of changes we might want to make. Senator King, I think you could be of immense help to us to make sure that we target.
You bet. And
okay.
Secretary Vilsack is going to name a new chief within the next couple weeks.
Great.
And I'll stick around to transition with the new chief, maybe we'll even bring both of us up.
Well, we have a subcommittee, Senator Hickenlooper subcommittee. We will get right with him. Brian will work with him and assist Senator Hickenlooper from our staff, the energy staff, and we'll work with Senator King's staff also to make sure that we can get a direct target on what we need to do immediately.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Senator King, do you have any other questions?
And Senator Manchin, can I just, for the record, state that in the, my exchange with Senator Risch that background checks for on performance is something we do in our hiring processes.